morning, students. As you know, this year the exam pattern is completely changed. It is made semester system, just like in engineering semester. Similarly, you have to appear the board exam in two phases. First one is your terminal 1, terminal 2. Accordingly, 50% of syllabus is assigned for terminal 1, which will be MCQ pattern type. And 50% of syllabus is there. Board has already released the circular regarding the syllabus division. Okay. Most important thing is you have to also appear practical exam twice. Earlier you are appearing once, here you have to appear twice. That means one for terminal 1, other for terminal 2. As per the guideline, you have to maintain at least four experiments. And three activities in your record. Experiment copy is separate, activity copy is separate. And which four experiments to be retained, which three activities to be retained, that will be communicated to you through the WhatsApp group, or you can collect it from lab assistant sir, no problem. But today we are going to perform one experiment. And it is our duty and responsibility to complete at least four experiments. Maintain it in the laboratory record, make it cross-checked from any one of the teacher, either me or Panda sir. Also, three activities to be written in one activity record, those to be submitted before the external in the time of exam. Is that clear? And so far as the syllabus concerned, that is already there in CBSE site, you can get it. And which experiments are there allotted in first term, you can read it also there. Out of those four experiments to be performed, one of the experiment is this: to find resistivity of two or three wires using Ohm's law, using the V versus I graph and Ohm's law. So all of you aware about Ohm's law in standard 10? Okay, here we will be doing that in practical manner. That means we will be taking the instruments. You can see the instrument here. This is the battery eliminator, means your source. This is the key. This is the rheostat. This is the voltmeter. This is the ammeter, and this is that unknown wire which resistivity to be calculated. So for that, what you need to have a V versus I graph. You know, as per Ohm's law, potential difference across any portion of a conductor, or potential difference across any conductor, directly proportional to the current passing through it, provided there are some conditions like temperature constant, mechanical strain is not there. So V versus I graph for ohmic conductors is generally a straight line. Okay, so if you see, this is the circuit diagram. This is there in your textbook also. This is the connection battery. Positive end is connected ammeter plus. There you see, here is the battery plus. It is connected to ammeter plus. Okay, then ammeter negative is connected to the unknown wire as well as voltmeter in parallel. Voltmeter positive is there. So ammeter negative is connected to voltmeter positive as well as unknown wire in parallel. Then voltmeter negative to rheostat. So voltmeter negative to rheostat. This is your rheostat. Okay, then other part of the rheostat is connected to the source, to the key. So here is the key, here is the source, the negative of the source. This is the circuit part. Then come to the theory. Actually, what we are going to do? We are actually supposed to find resistance from V versus I graph. This is the V versus I table. What we will take from this, through this instrument, 10 voltage reading, corresponding 10 current reading. Okay, we will be taking it. and will apply in form of a graph. The graph is expected to be a straight line starting from the origin because your 0,0 function is there. Okay, it is expected to be a straight line. Although there is a V versus I column in the tabulation of your reference book or the practical book, you don't have to calculate it. Okay, although you may not mention in terms of no problem, you have to simply write serial number, ammeter reading, voltmeter reading, and V versus I graph to be plotted using a graph paper. Once the points you obtain, and once you connect all the points, and once you obtain, it is a straight line. Remember, there is possibility few reading may go outside the point or outside the line. So our job is only to accumulate maximum number of points which are coming on under the straight line. Rest of the point you can leave it, no problem. So after, say for example, suppose your one point is here, leave it. One reading is here, one reading is here, leave it. Okay, then take the slope. This was taught to you in theory. Slope. So you have to give you resistance. And that will keep you in ohm. Why? Because so after getting the resistance, your next job is to find the length of the wire. Length of the wire L should be in certain centimeter. It has to be calculated or it has to be taken taking the meter scale. Simply take this wire from here, stretch it, and take one length, approximate length of the wire. Then your job is to find diameter of the wire. Why you are finding diameter? Certain millimeter it should be. Using screw gauge. Why screw gauge? Because screw gauge has a distance of up to 3rd measure decimal. So it can give you the reading in millimeter. Okay, so take this wire again, take its reading using screw gauge. How it is taken, that is already told you in standard 11. So after getting the diameter, you can go for the calculation. What is the calculation? Resistance is rho L by A, from which resistivity can be calculated as rho R A by L, and A area cross section for a cylindrical wire is pi D square by 4. So your resistivity will be pi R D square by 4A. This is the formula. Pi R D square by 4A. So put these values here. You are expected to get the resistivity of the order of 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter. Why? Because we are using one alloy wire here. Alloy has resistivity of the order 10 to the power minus 8. Coefficient may be from 44 to 100. Okay. So this is the experiment you have to do. Now let us come to the instrument. So far as the instrument is concerned, that already I explained you that battery alimenter, ammeter, voltmeter, wire in parallel, then rheostat, then key. So you have to only change the resistance of the circuit. While changing the resistance of the circuit by sliding the rheostat, what will the parameter and voltmeter, it is also changing. So you have to switch it on. So for different values of V, different values of I to be taken, and the VI values we apply to get the graph. From the graph, slope to be taken, and that slope will give you the average resistance of the wire. After that, the length, then the diameter using screw gauge, using which you can calculate the resistivity. This is your first experiment. Any doubt? So one by one or in table, you may now perform the experiment.